What's up, everyone?
Oh shit, tired. This video is not going to take long. I'm ready to go to bed. But anyway, saw this on eBay and had to pick it up. I loved it since I saw it. Really been on like a Death Studios hunt lately, like a lot of people have been saying it, you know. Getting different news for different things, you know, distortions always, death, Don Post things. You know, you're always on the hunt for certain things that you might like from each company. This was one of the pieces I really liked. I just love the way the mask looks, and I didn't want to go Tots route, or Trick Treat Studios, sorry, route with it, because they go to certain companies and pick up certain masks that they can sell through their company and mass produce. This is obviously not the mass produced version. This is the OG. He was sending out a styrofoam head. Looky there. So this is Cthulhu 92. So this is, I think this is an original from Death Studios. Cthulhu. Based off the H.P. Lovecraft, so, mythical, creature, aliens, whatever, I'm huge into, like, serpents, and anything to do with, like, fish tanks, and shit. I just picked up a few other goodies, predator fish, for my home, for my fish tanks here. So this mask definitely it was just a captivating octopus looking fucking, you know, just cool, man. It's just cool as shit. What's not to love about this mask? Super dope. So I saw it. It's like this dude was listing a bunch of things, and it's really a heavy duty mask. Solid still to this day. There's no cracking. Very well made. Thick mask. You can see right above the eye holes there. There's eye holes right there. So yeah, man, Cthulhu was awesome. Pull that little thing off. 92, I think this is the original. I'm not sure if it came out in the 80s or not. So, but yeah, this thing's fucking, this thing rocks. So, you set it right there and check it out. I'm gonna have to figure out something to jack him up, put him on a stand or something, put him in the room. But for tonight, I'm gonna go to bed. I just wanted to pop this video up real quick for all you guys. I thought it was cool. I mean, I don't see a lot of the originals like this pop up. You know, like you can go on Trick or Treat Studios and pick a copy up if you want. The paint is way different. It's like gray with dark eyes are darker. Whatever, but yeah, man, definitely a lot better since I got it home than it is in the pictures that he had. The background he had was kind of killing the mask, but yeah, up close and personal, man, this thing's badass. It's definitely mint. There's no rot or wear or tear on this mask at all. It's a thick mask. I'm just gonna display it, but definitely badass. And, yeah, man, I don't know how many of you guys have this, you know, an OG copy or whatever, but it always helps, you know. So, yeah, this is definitely going to fit in into the tribe of my masks. It's just kind of weird, but still kind of satanic. I go for the dark, so I like the dark stuff, you know, like the dark, creepy shit, and I think he definitely fits that bill, you know. You see so many zombies and vampires and all that shit, you know. There's nothing wrong with that, but what's whatever you're into. But yeah, this dude is just very cool. So, mythical creature, H.P. Lovecraft influenced, Cthulhu. I guess there's different ways to say that, but that's like the main way. I mean, that's like how everybody says it, I guess. Cthulhu! So 92 Death Studios, some old school shit here. Cool, man. Really, really cool. I don't know if they made these in the 80s or not. I don't know if this mask originated in the 80s. I'm not sure. Maybe you guys could help me with that. You know, like I said, I haven't really been collecting vintage masks long. I started out with busts and then kind of went, you know, I kind of just really, I started collecting masks as well with the busts, and then the masks just took over, and then the busts, I'm just kind of, just not really into it. I still have a few busts, but, you know, who knows? Somebody might make something really, really cool, and I can't live without it, and, you know, like most of the shit, and you keep it for a while, enjoy it, and then pass it on, or some things you just can't pass on. But yeah, I love this thing. Fucking awesome. I also have some Nightmare Force stuff coming. Two pieces from my buddy Josh. Real excited about those. Some black on black stuff. Real cool, real dark, real evil shit. The one piece is like a one-off, or it's the beginning of a variant that he's offering now, but it's the first one that was done, I believe. I'm not sure. Anyway, Josh does incredible work over at Nightmare Force. He just moved to a bigger facility that's easier for him to work and get things out. You know, that guy's awesome. Josh's work and his ethics speak for themselves. So, top titties. You know, his 2018 lineup is, from what I heard, is sounding really promising. So I cannot wait to see, you know, what he comes up with first. But yeah, man, I'm gonna end this video. I guess I'll bring you guys in for a little bit of a, you know, close up of it. I'm sure, you know, you guys could pull up some catalog photos of this dude if you want. But yeah, he's mint. There's no flaking of the paint. I mean, it looked like it was made yesterday. 92. Really cool. Super fucking thick, man. He put it on a head form, so I'm just gonna, it has the hole right there, so I'll get a dowel rod, stick it in that, and then put it on a base, and you know, attach the dowel rod to the base, preset the screw, and all that shit, and I guess he's pretty heavy, he'll just fall over if I don't. So yeah, you can see in there, the head, in the mirror there, it's kind of cool reflection. There you go, maybe like that, that's a badass. But yeah, Cthulhu rocks. There's nothing bad I can say about how cool this dude is. Like Octopus Man. Fucking awesome. Yep. Very cool. Very cool. You guys have a great night.